Hi, welcome to Free Spirit and welcome to a special Manifesting with the Moon reading. So we're going to get spirit messages about manifesting with the moon. So we're going to tap into moon manifestation cards. We're going to tap into the moonology cards for advice. And I think we're going to get a lot. We're going to tap into Queen of the Moon and we're going to tap into the Zodiac Moon. So it's all moon, moon, moon. So I just want to tap in and go and just get guided and receive messages. This is all about manifesting with the moon. So let's get messages, clear messages, manifesting with the moon. So this is manifesting with the moon inside and out, inside out. That's what they're saying, inside out. So manifesting with the moon inside out. So let's see what are the messages that want to come through when we are manifesting with the moon inside out. Manifesting with the moon inside out. I'm so curious what's going to come out as well. So let's just get ready to receive manifesting with the moon. Special spirit reading. What messages want to come through about manifesting with the moon? What wants to come through? Manifesting with the moon. Manifesting with the moon. This is for any time you find this video. This is going to just be anytime you find this video. Manifesting with the moon from the inside out. Manifesting with the moon from the inside out. What are the messages from? Clear messages when we're manifesting from the moon. By the way, we are getting focus on the positive. So the number one card that wants to come through right now, manifesting with the moon, is to focus on the positive. So whatever you're doing, and it's very easy, and this has been coming through over and over again, it's so easy, the gravity of the world, to go negative, to go dark. I call it the gravity of the world. It's with our thoughts as well. So focus on the positive. New moon in Sag. Whenever you're setting your sights on something, you're going farther in your life, keep focusing on the positive as you do, as you're striving for things. And we're getting, yeah, take a reality check. Full moon in Capricorn. So this could be a time when you're really being very practical, grounded, and really eyeballing everything in your life from a really realistic standpoint. So focus on the positive and take a reality check. So it almost feels like opposite, but it's not. So it's like, focus on the positive, but don't be Pollyanna about it. Just focus on the positive, but at the same time, be very realistic about everything. So you could be tackling really practical matters. And we've been getting that a lot about practicality at this time. So at the same time, you are focusing on the positive, absolutely, while you're striving. But at the same time, you have a brilliant flashlight, like on everything that's in your reality, everything that's going on in the physical in your life. This could be, especially with your finances and with your work and what needs to be done. It's like you are just really eyeballing. The moon could really be showing you where to get also a reality check on things in the physical. Like what can you take control of and take care of, and really shining a light on practical matters. So you could really be eyeballing your day-to-day practically grounded methodically and everything else. But at the same time, when you're looking at those things, also remain focused on the positive. So that's really interesting. And when you're taking an eyeball look at everything, continue to focus on the positive. So even if there's things to do or fix or make better, you're focusing on the positive, but at the same time, you're very grounded in reality. So what a powerful combination to actually practically get things done, right? So you're positive and you're striving for better and more and making and all of that, but at the same time, you're not Pollyanna up in the sky about it, that you're very practical and grounded and really based in reality, which is good because that means that you're grounded at the same time that you could actually get it done. So it's like, I love how the arrows pointed up with Sag. It's like you're so focused on the positive as you're going forward. But at the same time, it's really going to be based in reality and really based on your work and what you're trying to get accomplished practically, grounded. So this is very good combination, I do have to say, of what they're saying. And it's almost like the secret sauce for right now to stay positive, but then also be very grounded at the same time and get things done. And I feel that you could actually be seeing very brightly, very illuminated in your world right now in the physical with everything that you're doing and really assessing, reassessing, or seeing everything very clearly. And it could even be things that you weren't clearly actually seeing before. So now we're getting, yeah, take inspired action. So with these things, they're inspiring us to take inspired action. So here we have focus on the positive, take a reality check, make sure that everything is in based in reality, you're grounded, and then take that inspired action on the things in the physical. Absolutely. So that's what they're saying to do. So you're remaining positive, take a reality check, look at everything very practically grounded, and then take an inspired action. Let's get some further advice here from what they're saying when we take an inspired action in the physical to get things done. What are they saying is going to happen when we take those inspired actions? Let's see. Stay positive, stay grounded, take those inspired actions. I feel like when you get illuminated yourself with things in the physical, when you're looking at everything in reality here and you're getting inspired action, you're being encouraged to follow through with that. It's actually going to provide a lot of healing here and a lot of love I see here too. So take those actions here, and we're getting, it's time to take action. Expect powerful change. Make no doubt about it. Remain positive. Definitely we're getting reality checks, but a lot could be illuminated to us in the physical, and then we're inspired to take action on it because we're part of this expect powerful change and take, it's time to take action. So, and it's Aries. So this is really about taking inspired action, and you could be feeling that you're really guided at this time. The moon is supporting you to stay positive, to have a real reality check on everything that's going on in the physical. And then when you do, take that inspired action because expect powerful change. And so you're getting inspired, I think, also being a part of this powerful change. So if you're getting inspired action, you're going to be following through because it's like it's time to take action, expect powerful change. And it probably could be from the reality checks, being positive about and trying to make things better, being inspired to take those actions. Let's get the Queen of the Moon, because no doubt they want us to be the Queen of the Moon, because if you have to take action, you have to feel very powerful to make powerful changes, expect powerful changes, to be in your power for this. So no doubt we got the Queen of the Moon here. So what are the messages from the Queen of the Moon? Be the Queen of the Moon here, actually, when you're doing that inspired action. We're getting, yeah, focus. And look, a butterfly for the changes. So this is going to be all about focus. Keep your mind focused. Focus on the positive as you're striving forward. But it is definitely going to be a time for you to really focus now. And time for a positive change. Change starts in your mind, right? You have to see it visually and also, right, with your third eye. So stay focused on what you're doing. Be very tapped in with how you're feeling. I see how she, it feels like she's in water practically. Make sure that you're expecting positivity and that you're keeping, see, this was not about positivity, literally having a positive focus. It literally says focus on the positive. You can't make this up. It says focus and focus on the positive. So you have to make sure that in your mind, you're just filling it with focusing on the positive as you're taking inspired actions and expect great, powerful, wonderful changes. So just focus on that, which is a tall order. It's been a repeating message because there's everything pulling at our focus, right? Away from our inspired actions. Feeling it almost like takes the power away from us to remain focused on what we are to do, what you feel guided to do, what you're inspired to do. So there's something about staying focused on what you feel inspired to do and then expect powerful change. So stay positive through that. So let's see what are the other clear advice, but make no doubt about it. Just focus. And when you have inspired action, take it. Here we have, yes, yeah, and the nourishment. And no doubt what I was getting about this is nourish yourself, like focus and nourish yourself, like to support yourself when you're taking inspired action is what I'm getting. So focus and nourishment and take that inspired actions, absolutely. And your powerful dual spiritual tools are being really positive, making sure your mind is filled with positivity and you're focused, taking that inspired action. And it's based in reality. Like you are really It's like a flashlight on your reality in your physical. And when you take the inspired actions, stay positive, focused, expect that powerful change. It's time to take action. And you're being infused to be passionate in your power and to also be in your power, properly nourishing yourself. When you take inspired actions, it's like standing strong and supporting yourself and nourishing yourself to take that inspired action when you feel guided to do so. This is so incredible how it is just so linking up. Let's end it with the last messages from the moon, what the moon wants to reveal to us. Let's see. To nourish yourself as you're taking inspired actions and focus and stay positive. Also very grounded in reality, and you're seeing everything very clearly, like illuminated in your, take a reality check, like a proper assessment of everything in the physical. Stay positive and take inspired action and expect powerful change. Expect powerful change when you remain positive and focused and you're taking inspired actions. That's what they want. And to be strong in that, and not only that, but like nourish yourself. Like I said, this seems very love and healing that you're providing even to yourself as you take inspired actions. That's what they're saying. So, oh gosh, now we're getting to yes, regeneration. Higher purpose. I have chills. This is why. Regeneration. Yes. Stand firm in the eye of the storm. Stand firm in the eye of the storm. It reminds me of the palm trees I have in the Natural Oracle for Life Tech, where you weather the storms because your roots are firmly planted. You're nourishing yourself to be strong and focused and taking action, inspired action. You're standing firm in the eye of the storms. And Sun in Pisces, higher purpose. Higher purpose. Align yourself with love and wisdom. And you hear all the sirens going off? This is it. So this is a time where you could feel that it's a regeneration into your higher purpose, that you're doing what you can to stay focused, positive, taking inspired action. It's very grounded at the same time that you're staying positive. And when you're being infused to take inspired action, expect powerful changes and nourish yourself along the way. That is the clear message that the moon wants to come through, that you could feel also that you're getting more aligned to your higher purpose, that you're actually getting assistance in doing that, in staying aligned. You align yourself with love and wisdom, and then you're actually taking inspired action in that alignment. And there's been a lot coming through about support for this alignment and taking inspired action from that point. And then also the divine has really, and it's seven, which is divine, but the divine is nourishing us to be that way, and also for us to be that way for ourselves, so that we're staying positive, brightly understand, like bright illumination on everything that's in the physical. And we are inspired and strong enough to take the strong in the storms, to take those inspired actions, because those, when you align with yourself with love and wisdom, you're taking those inspired, you're focused and taking those inspired actions. It's leading to powerful change. It's leading to really powerful change. So this has been the special moon guidance reading that wanted to come through, very clear messages. And with the sound of the bell, I gotta go. And I wish you the best with all your inspired actions to nourish yourself along the way. Stay focused and positive, and welcome to being more aligned with your higher purpose and being strong in the storm and carrying through everything that you're inspired to do, because it's creating powerful change. I wish you the best. Take care. Bye-bye.